Hello, we're the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode, we have a bunch of SpaceX updates to look at, plus a whole bunch of stuff going on in Boca Chica. Then we have some information from Elon Musk, other Starship pieces, plus a bit of SN5, SN6 and SN7. Quite a bit to cover today, so let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting off with the recent launch of Starlink 7. As most of you will know, the rocket lifted off successfully for the fifth time on Wednesday, June 3rd. Ignition. The booster then proceeded to make history by becoming the first orbital class rocket booster to land for the fifth time.
And wow, as you saw coming down, that first stage Falcon 9.
In other Starlink and launch news, it's looking like we could have an exciting month of June. As Michael Baylor has tweeted, SpaceX appears to be targeting no earlier than June 12th or 13th for their next Starlink mission per marine hazard zones. On top of this, he also tweeted that the following Starlink mission, Starlink 9, is also expected this month. Not only that, but SpaceX are also apparently expected to launch GPS-3 this month. So as you can see on the SpaceXFans website, there's a great looking launch cadence for this month, but as always, this is subject to potential weather delays. The next thing to show you are a couple of shots from Julia Bergeron. On the left, you can see the newer version of Octagrabber, and on the right is the older version. Some assumptions were made by people thinking this was the new Octagrabber we saw recently under construction. However, after speaking with Julia, she said, "I am now pretty positive that the new one is indeed on Just Read the Instructions and they upgraded the one you can see here on Of Course I Still Love You." Something notable about this new version is what it allows SpaceX to do, as you will see in my next point. The new version should also be able to grab hold of Falcon Heavy center core, something the old version couldn't. Here you can see B1051 sitting in port after returning from Demo 2. What I want to point out is that this booster had its legs retracted while still on Of Course I Still Love You. Usually, when they retract the legs, they take the rocket off the drone ship and place it on a special stand. So this is a new capability of the Octagrabber and will allow them to speed up the recovery process. The final piece of SpaceX news is quite exciting and a pretty big change to the commercial crew program. Apparently, NASA have granted SpaceX permission to fly reused boosters and Crew Dragon capsules for commercial crew missions. Quickly before we move on to Boca Chica, let's see some updates from Elon Musk. He started by tweeting this amazing aerial shot of the Starship production facility. He was then asked by NASA Spaceflight if there were any more additions we can look forward to. Musk responded with, "Giant high bay coming soon." He was then asked arbitrarily what it might be used for. Musk responded to say that its purpose will be for super heavy stacking. Apparently, it will also be 81 meters tall. Everyday Astronaut also responded to somebody else's tweet about making a high bay for stacking both Starship and Super Heavy together. He said that based on renders, he thinks it makes sense to stack them at the pad. Musk responded to him and confirmed that that's the intention, but apparently even that will be an adventure. Now over to Boca Chica where, as I said, a whole bunch of things have been going on. Starting with the old test stand, which you cannot see here because it has been dismantled and removed from the launch area. To add to this, work on the new launch mount has really picked up in recent days. As you can see here, the mount was placed on a roll lift and moved over to where the old stand was. As well, engineers have continued to work on the test stand to get it ready for SN5, which should arrive very soon. More on SN5 testing in a bit. There are also some new arrivals to the launch area which look like they could be parts of a mount. Maybe SpaceX are preparing to build another test stand, which could make sense given how quickly SN6 is coming together. This new piece of equipment also recently arrived at the launch area. I had assumed, and turns out it was, a piece of ground support equipment, as you can see it being lowered into the test stand. Also, some new pipes were delivered to the launch area, so the new mount should be ready very soon. The SN4 explosion obviously sent pieces flying all over the place. Here's some more damage that was caused where a piece got wedged in a tank. SpaceX have also been seen working at the fuel farm as a new tank has arrived. I'm sure somebody in the comments can tell me what this tank is for. However, as you can see here, it has been placed upright to be hooked up for SN5's arrival. Over in the construction area, a new crane has arrived. Even though I don't know much about it, my guess was that it was going to be used for the new ring fabrication building. As you can see here, turns out that I was correct and it has been moved inside that building. I can't wait to see this building start churning out pieces of Starship. Let's now look at some other Starship pieces that have been seen. Starting with this already sleeved dome in an onion tent. I may be wrong, but I'm assuming it's Corey's Tucko Dome since it doesn't look very Starship worthy. There is also still the new nose cone that we saw in the tent being worked on. Still a bit too small and still not sure which SN version this is intended for. With SN4 gun, all eyes are now on SN5, who we are expecting to create just as good, if not a better legacy than its predecessor. You can see here it is still chilling in the high bay with SN6. Recently, some new legs were spotted being moved around in a construction yard. They look very similar to some of the renders I've seen of the legs, so we'll be cool to see these things pop out from underneath. The nose cone ring stack for SN5 that recently folded in on itself doesn't look too bad now. Maybe they are still planning to use it, but I doubt we will see SN5 get a nose cone until after proof testing. There has also been some news with regards to the rollout and testing. Michael Baylor tweeted that rollout of Starship SN5 to the pad is scheduled for Monday, June 8th, with proof testing to begin no earlier than Wednesday, June 10th. Here you can see the latest road and beach closures by Cameron County. As we just saw, there's tomorrow, Monday 8th for rollout and Wednesday, June 10th for testing. Then there's also June 11th and June 12th as testing backup days. Get ready, launch area, SN5 is coming. For now though, let's take a look at the final two Starships at the moment, SN6 and SN7. Here you can see the SN6 thrust section which we recently saw got sleeved. It has now been attached to the flipping mechanism. Then, as expected, they flipped it over in preparation for stacking. It's still sitting outside, so the stacking phase should be coming very soon and then we'll have a full SN6 tank. Finally, last episode we saw that an SN7 bulkhead was moved outside, as were the rings. Then it was sleeved to form what I was assuming would be the top of the SN7 tank. However, here you can see yet another liquid oxygen tank dome that was moved outside and onto the sleeving mount. It was then sleeved with a two-ring stack. The height of these rings appears to be quite a bit smaller than what we usually see, so this is a bit odd. What's also strange is that this bulkhead says forward dome SN7, so it's definitely for SN7. I've seen somebody suggest that maybe it could be a bopper like we saw with SN2. I'm not entirely sure why they would need a bopper since the recent failures weren't Starship related. Though I doubt it will be long before we find out how this will be used. As always, a massive thank you to Mary Boca Chica Girl, who always gets a wide variety of amazing footage. Also, a thank you to Julia Bergeron and the rest of the NSF team for all their incredible work. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.